Hi, I am Pushpraj Singh. I am from PGP 1719 batch of Indian Institute of Management, Trichy. As a part of my course curriculum of Indian Economic Policy, I am going to talk about social infrastructure and its impact on Indian economy. Infrastructure can majorly be divided into two parts, social and physical. Social infrastructure consists of assets that accommodate social services. It includes schools, universities, hospitals, and community houses, health and sanitation. Economic development depends on existence of an integrated infrastructure or social overhead capitals, which generates externalities. This is why, since 1956, a serious attempt has been made to build heavy industry in the public sector. In fact, one of the cause for expansion of public sectors in India has been infrastructure building. Heavy industries such as iron and steel, coal, power plants, petroleum, heavy engineering are essentially input supplying industry. However, the persistence of low level of human development is one of the paradoxes of Indian development experiences. A substantial boost for the social sector in the near future will ensure that government will carry forward the inclusive growth agenda effectively. Human capitals are one of the chief means of economic success. Economic development depends not only on the economic infrastructure like a very developed transport and communication network or the extension of irrigation facilities in dry area, but also on social infrastructure. Human capabilities depends upon basic education, health services, ownership patterns, social satisfaction, gender relations, and opportunity for social cooperation. Education and health are not only public goods but merit goods as well. They generate positive externalities in the sense that marginal social benefit far exceeds the private benefit. So, these are undersupplied. Actual output is less than socially desirable levels. This is an example of market failures and calls for optimal correction through grants and subsidies. Education, in every sense, is a fundamental factor for development of any country. No country can achieve sustainable economic development with sustainable investment in human capitals. Similarly, healthcare is one of the major determinants of labor productivity and efficiency. Multinational companies are not only focused on providing medicines, but also expanding economic opportunities by providing job and providing trainings. We must recognize the intrinsic importance of human capability and effective freedom as the end of social and political organization. The first and most important task we face is the elimination of illiteracy, ill health, and other avoidable deprivation. India continues to make good progress in increasing economic incomes and improving living standards over the past decades. Since the adoption of economic reform program in July 1991 in the context of structural adjustment program, poverty continues to decline and many social indicators, in particular literacy, continues to improve. In low developing countries like India, development of social infrastructure is vitally important for achieving faster economic growth and alleviating poverty. India's 5-year plan has failed to eliminate poverty, at least because of four reasons: malnutrition, poor health, lack of learning opportunities, and limited growth. Good education, health, nutrition, low fertility helps to reduce poverty by increasing opportunities to generate right income. By the same token, an improving standard of living leads to gain in health and education, freeing people from the trap of ignorance and exposure to diseases. There is a positive correlation between health and education. Education empowers people to use information and lead a better healthy behavioral choices. The healthy are more likely to attend schools and go to work and can learn and work effectively. Coming to the health sector, these have also improved, but they have a long way to go, particularly among the poor. No doubt, life expectancies at the birth improved from 51 to 61 between 1973 and 2003, and the infant mortality has decreased from 137 to 74 per 1,000 live births. On the demographic front, fertility has declined from 3.6 births per woman in 2003 compared to 6 in 1951. What are the major challenges that India is facing in the social services? Indian social services are facing major challenges: a growing population, industrialization, and a globalizing economy that places premium on information and technology are stretching the capacity of Indian educational system to deliver and relevant effective services. Yet enormous task remains. Getting 33 million children from the poor families into primary school, increasing the retention rate so that more children can finish primary grades, and upgrading the average quality of schooling received. In health, country is undergoing an epidemiological transition. There continues to be a high rate in communicable diseases, malnutrition, and maternal and paternal illness, representing a large unfinished agenda that predominantly affects the poor. Three broad strategies that can help in reforming the healthcare is to, number one is to use public information more strategically to empower considerable of healthcare and enable people to provide better their own healthcare, rejuvenating the public sector to better deliver its core services, engaging the private sector to better meet the societal health. The private sector needs to engage as an agent to meet basic societal goal of good education, particularly for the poor. Private sector should collaborate with the government to provide a good health benefits to people around India. Coming to the educational sector, Indian government is trying its best to increase the social infrastructure in India. We can see from the budget of 2017-2018, government has allocated rupees 85,000 crores for the educational sector starting year 1 April 2018. The low hike in the educational sector was hinted in the budget of 2018 speech. Finance Minister Mr. Arjun Jaitley unveiled a new scheme called as RISE. The RISE scheme will finance via restructuring higher education financing agency that is functioning for the last 2 months as a non-banking financial sectors. So this is all from me. Thank you.